Testing, testing. Testing, testing. Can you hear me, Harley?
Yeah, I can hear you, yeah. Yeah, all right.
Wedding Paul and Snooker. Cheeky little money game for a Friday night.
Yeah.
Andy Johnson, Harley Hall. Hello, world. If anyone's watching this mass, okay. You alright?
Yeah, I'm good, you?
Yeah, not too bad.
Just busy setting up the stream, you've been.
Yeah. Busy times. I've got the twisted cable. Awesome. Can stay at that. Try and untwist it.
Oh. Uh-huh. Just play a snooker there, keep just trying to keep in control of the frame. Laverick, of course, if you guys were here about 5 minutes ago, or probably less than 5 minutes ago, he had a chance and got unlucky, cannoned into a ball and snookered himself on this last red. And then he got out of the snooker and went off, so bit of fortune in Jamie's favour in this first frame. A good hit, that one.
Back in the room. So how do you see this match going, Harley?
Well, I see it going very close at the moment. Mm.
I think so too. I think it's going to be a close one the whole way.
That'll do you, Joe.
Oh, he's not quite hit that.
Good chance. Yeah, he just tried to cover the pocket there, didn't he?
I think he's going for the putt, to be honest.
You think? Yeah, maybe. Suppose, yeah, even if you... This put harder, but oh, I think that covered.
just using our eagle eye. Our eagle eye Bradley says he hasn't got a clue whether it goes or not.
Oh, bit of a chance here. If you take the ball at the top Yeah, you take the ball near the middle of the table, you take it up, probably into the top right, then the white comes around and you get the snooker if, even if you miss. That's the shot he's looking at, I think, already. Yeah, he's just, I don't know whether he went for, I don't think he went for the pot there. I think he's just played to push it up over the pocket and get the snooker, which is not a bad shot, but he could get out of this and could either get the pot in the corner. Sorry, we had a bit of an issue there. We said 1-0 Jamie already, which is 0-0. I think AJ must have accidentally pushed the button when he was doing that. Poor effort at a snooker, really, that one. Ooh, that was a big chance, that. He's good chance for this frame here.
That was a good chance, isn't it, Ali? He's going to put his red safe now as well.
Yeah, so he could take this one up into the top corner, probably. Maybe, is he enough into the middle if you play it? Do you, maybe, or?
I don't know. I think it hits the cushion before the middle.
You think?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it's... The angle's there to run down for this bottom one. Mm. If he runs down for it, then all he's got to do is...
It'd be a hard pot on the red wherever he loses it, to be honest.
Yeah. Shot. Ooh, is it a bit hard? Is it the draw? Has he got a bit of luck? He has. Really fortunate.
Apologise, but he's got smelling roses. Now, do you play it long, dead straight, or do you just drop this in?
I think you drop it in dead weight. Do you not? Or you play it on off? No, you don't play the one on top. I wouldn't. If you would you?
No, I suppose you play it middle pocket and you go drift across. You might actually get a snooker as well behind the black if you play the one. So that yellow's a bit tricky, isn't it, in the middle pocket?
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. Like, that is a. It's quite a hard pot to play, considering you know that you're going to leave. Oh, that's why he's turned it down. He's playing the one in the middle.
Yeah, I don't mind that. There's an automatic snooker, so you might, if you don't get it, just play it with confidence.
That's a good shot, that one.
It would have been a hard red pot from there, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Drop this one in. All he's got to do is run off the bottom cushion. Whether we can hold for the middle or not is a different matter, but definitely be able to play it for the corner.
Yeah. Well, I'm just rolling this in smoothly. Leave the ball in the bottom cushion somewhere. You play in the middle pocket. Just drop it in. He's done neither.
Thing is, the red's safe. It's a free shot. Play it up into the corner, then the white runs towards the top cushion.
You've got a nice angle to... His break is now. It's his first break of the match.
That white
was going very close, wasn't it?
Early stage, really early stages, but he's getting a couple of flicks here, a couple of there, just bits of luck. He Jamie was telling me earlier that he thinks it's key that he gets a good start.
Okay. Do you think if he goes behind, he'll be a bit...
I think so. I think it as well.
His head will go down.
Yeah.
I think they're both a little bit like that, to be honest. I think when Mike played his match against Bradley, he was doing okay at the start, but then Bradley kicked on and Mike's head went down a little bit, I think.
Yeah. Seeing...
Bradley O'Reilly in the house. Hello, Bradley.
Yeah. He just said hello. That shot was maybe, I don't know, maybe an unneeded cannon yeah. there.
You're playing the winner, Bradley, are you?
No comment.
No comment.
Yeah. He said he'd play Mike again, but wouldn't want to play Jamie because they're good mates.
That's not
a bad shot, that. It's good. Oh, great white ball, that. He's not sure he's played for that white.
He definitely hasn't played that because he's definitely playing the pot. And if he turns around and says he was playing the pot, then what was he going for next?
Yeah. Either way, another bit of run there. Yeah. Fell nicely for Jamie, let's yeah. say.
Mike had his chances in the first frame, didn't quite take them.
Yeah.
But it's a...
couple of good pots from Jamie in that first frame as well.
Long race though, first to 21.
Yeah, very early doors.
Mike's just going to get out.
For me, that's a poor shot.
I think he's trying to double it in the top, but...
didn't get very close to that.
Not the end of the world though, because he's cleared the pocket.
I suppose so. That red still stayed open. The only thing is, though, all of these yellows go, don't they? So
yeah. Interesting to see how Jamie takes these. There's a few options here, isn't there?
Yeah. Which ball do you leave till last? In your opinion. I'd pick up the white here if it was me.
Yeah. The coaching manual says do it in areas. So I think you clear the top two first.
Yeah.
Then you screw down the left-hand side of the table. Then you should be on one of the two at the top.
He's not looking at playing these two at the top.
I think the hardest ball on the table is won by the black, so I can see why he's playing it.
Yeah. Maybe he thinks he can get up from the top of the table back down here. It's gone safe, but he should still expect to pot that down the cushion.
I think this one goes in the corner, though, comfortably.
Yeah.
It's going to do what we said about areas, but it's going to do it the other way around, which you don't mind.
Yeah, but it's just the only shot there. Makes it a bit awkward, is getting on the black. Mm-hmm. Last yellow to black, or this ball to the next. This is a key shot. Get yourself nicely on the next ball.
Ooh, now how do you do this? Do you swing it around?
I swing it around with a bit of right hand side, I'd say. Yeah. A little bit of right hand side.
I'll tell you what, or do you just screw it straight back? Should we screw it straight back?
One cannon, you're snookered.
Yeah, there's a small funnel there to get it into.
Yeah.
If you swing it around like it's indicating now, there's a big target there.
Yeah.
A bit of 7 o'clock on a cue ball, do you think?
See, this is where I could see. Just a bit of tension, maybe a bit too much right hand side running into the reds. I'm not sure, but
yeah.
Oh,
he's hit
got into the bottom of the ball, but and he's running off.
It was certainly spinning, but it was spinning with too much screw.
Yeah, he should have just stunned the white rather than. I think he just got into the white a bit too much. That's what I thought. I did say, bit of tension. Anything. This is Jamie's first big money match. These two played, I think, a few months ago as well.
Yeah, they played a couple months ago. It was 21-19 to Jamie Majid.
Yeah. Of course, close game there. We're expecting the same today.
Yep. See if Mike's going to free his hard ball or if he's going to pot this.
I'm not sure that's the shot I'd play, but maybe it's not.
I can see what he's doing here. He's just going to go left, right, left, right, left, right.
Yeah, he might just
drop this in.
Would you leave that ball on the side cushion until your last ball, or here, or play a cannon now? We could do.
Personally, I'd have played it out on my first shot, but
that's what I think. I think I'd be with you on that.
We're all different.
Yeah, I think he's playing a cannon. Is he?
I think just drop it in, maybe.
Oh, he has just dropped it in, but oh, is he ran behind it? He has. I think we all know the shot here.
Yeah.
Just a tuck up in behind the red. He's nearest too, but.
He's not going for a pot here, is he?
Surely not. He fell on it. Oh, you can't see it from that camera.
see if they push it or not.
It's tight. No, I think they've had a mutual decision as not to, but it's very questionable. It's a good, it's a decent plant that. This is a key shot. Thing is, I think in his head that was two.
Yeah.
But he knows. One good at ear. Tuning up. It's the start he would have wanted.
Yeah. I think he's got a natural angle. Just drop it in dead white. It's perfect. Just drop it in dead white.
It's the pot.
Ooh. As is lucky, he needs a cannon.
Ooh, it's not the best. It's not the best.
If he doesn't win this frame, if he thinks it was two shots, it might affect him.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, yeah.
He might go in off there as well.
That's a good pot. Where's the white? It's good. That's a great shot, that. Bit risky with that white. Bit risky with that white. Executive scorer, Bradley O'Reilly. I think Mike now. In his head, he'll be thinking he needs to get one on the board just to settle himself. I think after he's got one, be better. He'll be fine.
Yeah, I. Do you want me to trot out a Paul and Snooker cliche for you, Harley? The hardest frames to win
is the first and last. Is that what
exactly,
you're saying?
Yeah, yeah, exactly that. Yeah. Good knowledge, Harley. Good knowledge. And it's a cliche because it's true. They are the hot because there's the most pressure on the first one, last one. You got to get up and running, and you got to finish it off. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Hello to you, 14 of you watching, the 14 of you that are watching. So if you were to break the score, what would you say?
I would say the same thing. 20 and a half, 20 and a half. Best of 41. 20 and a half, 20 and a half. A draw.
I bet they both won't. I bet that don't happen.
Yeah. I haven't been right once. I've been close. I've had some 21-20s.
Yeah.
Jamie at the table.
Bet you get some good odds for that.
Yeah. As soon as you can't win half a frame.
It's not a bad shot.
Yeah, it's not a bad shot from Jamie there. He's moved Mike's ball away from the pocket. Mike just seeing if that red top of the two on the right-hand side goes in the middle pocket. Don't think it does. So he's going for one at the top of the table. Looking to move them as well, maybe? Oh, that's a good shot.
It's a good pot, but it's pointless.
Well, I don't know.
I suppose if that one goes through the middle, then. Yeah, I suppose.
If he can get through to the top one of the two...
It's tight. Well, I'm looking tight, at it. I'm not sure it goes.
You can certainly put it over the pocket, which might be useful for later.
But I think playing this, you're still getting it safe, aren't you?
Yeah.
Oh, he's left.
That's very tight.
He's still tied up one of the yellows at the same time.
Yeah.
But he's got a shot here, maybe, to get out. Would you play that?
Play the one in the middle pocket, the left middle pocket with the off the top cushion.
Yeah.
That'd be a good shot, Harley.
But I played a frame with Jamie earlier, and this table. Taking so much spin.
It's quick, isn't it? It's a lovely table. Do you know what I'm doing here, Harley? I'm playing the one he's playing, looking at now, bottom right. Then I'm rolling the one in bottom left. White comes up the side on the left-hand side. Then the yellow he's now playing goes in off the red.
Yeah, that's why. When you went the second,
he's unlucky there.
Yeah.
He's unlucky there.
He's got the red out and went in off.
Yeah. Now. Black ball rules, first thing to look at with your one free shot is A, do I put one of his balls safe, or B, can I get one of my balls out?
Could do both in one shot.
Both in one shot.
Push.
I don't know if you can get through to the one down the rail he's always looking at now, but if you can't, then I guess the shot is the yellow next to it onto the red.
Yeah.
Or if you can play it, I mean, you don't want to play a cannon if you don't have to. If you can just bump this red out, it's equally good. You should have the one in the opposite middle. That's what he's done.
I'll tell you, this has not worked out nice at all.
He's a bit unlucky there.
Yeah, he was.
If that doesn't come up the table, he's okay. He's still got this in the corner pocket, though. It's a little bit tight.
Quite thin, that. Control.
Yeah, it's
him being thin. Not the tallest, him not being the tallest doesn't help.
Just put a good stroke on it. Ooh.
Ooh.
So look at that.
Yeah.
That was quite a thin one.
Yeah, it wasn't easy. Now.
Now Jamie's hard ball is the one on the bottom cushion.
Do you screw back for it? I
think the one in the middle pocket isn't quite straight. So I think you can screw down for the one on the bottom cushion. That's okay. I would have liked it more in the middle of the table.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
But I think as long as he gets the pot, he comes up the... left-hand side of the table as we look.
Leave yourself on a choice of two.
Yeah.
Either the one up into the top right or the one in the right middle.
Yeah. What you don't do is smash the heck out of it because it'll rattle. He's got a nice confident stroke.
Oh, he has it hard.
He didn't hit it that hard at all.
And he's put his ball safe.
Yeah.
Giving him just a little smirk there.
Mike's got a nice little chance here. If he just drops this one in top pocket, he can play them... Just go down the table, top, then the second, then the third, then the fourth. Just work your way down the table. Just nice and confident. Just drop them in, nice and steady. Don't need much of the cue ball. Just drop them in, slow as you dare.
The only hiccup here is snookering himself, which he's done. Which he's going to have to change his change the way he's going about them now.
Yeah, so I don't think he can pop the one in the little pocket there. That was hard to hold, actually, to be honest.
Yeah.
But I think this one bottom of the table.
Yeah, now this is tough. Black's there.
Yeah, now I'm playing up and down. I'm playing the red in the right middle. I'm playing both in the same pocket.
You're playing both in the same pocket?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
if he hits that, if it's that 2 foot harder, he's got a roll in the middle pocket.
Yeah. Now he's got a real tester into this. I know.
And the thing with my shot as well is I wouldn't underhit it, because if you overhit it, you've got it in the bottom right as well.
Thing is... Yeah, this is the way I'd be playing. Play it with deep screw, get the white screw. Safe if you miss. Yeah. Yeah. And you get on the black.
Yeah.
Oh, I always saw him missing that thin side if he missed it. But it's a good white ball. Great white ball.
It's a good white ball. Tricky to pot one from there. But I think James got an easy snooker.
Yeah, just bump that one off the cushion.
Top cushion one. Just roll to the top cushion. It is pretty tight to the cushion. You don't get double kiss. But I think if you just trust the table, it is pretty true. Just slow as you dare again. We smash that. That's way too hard.
Yeah, maybe he felt more safe playing it that way. It's a good shot, that.
If he's played that way, then fair play. It was a low percentage shot for me. Didn't just roll into it. But
to be honest,
he's put his balls out.
I looked at that because... only because of the fact that the double kiss was there.
Okay.
Oh, that's a good shot. That's a great shot. But he's not exactly perfect on this black.
It was a good hit. It was a good hit. He's looking at cutting it back into the bottom left. A bit controversial. I'm not sure. I'd probably be going bottom right, but there you go. Whatever you fancy, whatever you're comfortable with.
He's feathered it. Oh, he's left it awkward as well. What do you play here then?
I play a little snooker, the one you next do. Just top it through.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that's the right shot as well.
It's just a percent. If there was an easier pot, fair enough. But I think you can top the one that you're next to. Or even just roll to it, send the yellow one off the cushion. Even if you'll get the white forward a couple of inches and you're perfect.
Yeah.
Snooker. Actually, not a bad shot. If you can develop the yellow as well, put it over the pocket. Double
maybe he wants to
across.
Play the double, try and get a snooker at the same time.
Yeah, it's a harder snooker.
Yeah.
I think James is going for harder snookers than he needs to. But I think he's
got
that
the pot, it's a great shot.
He was playing that a two-way shot there, wasn't he? Pot and a bit of safety at the same time.
Yeah.
This is a thin one.
I think he'd prefer it not to go in now. He's looking at the plant, but I do not think that is the right shot. I think he's playing it. He is playing it. He's took it on and got the snooker.
He's got lucky there.
Very, very lucky.
He might say half played it.
Yeah. Maybe, but either way, he didn't play that as his primary shot, did he?
Oh, no.
I wasn't sure he went.
So Mike, after you potted the one last time out of the snooker, can you do it again?
Oh, could he hit it? See, now this, he needs to take these chances, Jamie.
I bet both players do.
Yeah. I think this will be quite a scrappy match, really.
So I think you just roll this through, and it's not the end of the world if the white finishes where the yellow is, maybe a couple of inches further down the table. Then you play the other two balls in the bottom left. And if you rattle it, it's not the end of the world. Just a nice smooth stroke. Just top it forward a couple of inches.
Yeah, just 3 or 4 inches further forward than where the yellow is now.
What you don't want to do is smash it and send the yellow up beside cushion somewhere.
Yeah, you want to control this. Oh, he's got a kick, has he?
I don't know if it was a kick or if he just didn't get topspin on it. But he's still at the same shot. So he's just chip it in, go up the table, black in the same pocket. Finish your dare.
He's got the pot.
He's got the pot.
He's got a shot at the black, that's the main thing.
Yep.
It's not easy, but one you'd expect him to get.
Yes.
Probably, yeah. Probably the easier of the blacks he's potted so far.
Where's the white?
It's just got enough side on it. Just about.
I didn't think he played it with side, though.
You don't think he did? I suppose there's no real reason for him to play it with side, so... Yeah, look. It isn't the most comfortable 3-0 lead you've ever seen, really, is it? Every frame's been quite tight.
No.
Either player could win it. tied up the ball on the right hand side of the table now. This is really going to be a scrappy frame at the moment, I think.
Yeah.
Another one.
Mike's favourite at the moment because the yellow and red top left favour reds.
He's playing the cannon now. He looked at it, but yeah, he's decided against playing the cannon to the top, the ball in the top left. Instead, he's got a nice flick and landed on this one, which I think, yes, you can play this one and screw into that one. Stun screw into that one on the top of the table.
I'm personally not going anywhere near it yet because it's kind of like your insurance ball. I think this is... that's a nice shot. I'm personally trying to get the one out on the right-hand side cushion.
Now, I'd be playing just rolling, get the red out and rolling beyond the yellow, would you not?
You might leave it open for the yellows. I don't mind that shot.
Tied up a couple of his yellows, probably unintentionally, but...
Yeah. I think I don't mind the shot there. I think he was trying to free his reds. I don't mind the shot choice. As far as Jamie, I'm not sure I'll be freeing them while the balls are tied up top left.
That's a good shot though, that.
That's a good shot.
Seems to be one shot every frame. Mike's just not quite getting right.
Yeah.
Either way, these yellows are a task in itself.
Yep.
Massive task.
You could free the one top pocket now, or could you launch?
He's moving the yellow. I'd be moving the red just because the yellow's over the pocket.
If he's doing this, you put the white on the yellow spot and play the plant first. Okay, I see what he's tried there.
He's tried to get them all out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he might have got a bit of luck here, has he? Well, he's freed everything, but mostly yellows.
Again, it comes back to if that yellow goes top right or not. Sorry, top left.
Yeah. Good thing is there. He's kept that hard yellow on the side, on the right-hand side of the table. And not left anything easy apart from the one over the pocket.
Mm-hmm.
So he can't... The wrong shot, or?
But bottom right.
Yeah, just push it.
Yeah, don't mind it. The only thing is, he might be able to play the red down the line, up the line. Miss it. You might go off the yellow as well. Just roll it through.
Oh, he's hitting the yellow full ball. Pushing okay. The yellow. Just made the clearance slightly harder as well. Not the easiest start. I'll play the one up the cushion, probably. Unless you do play the one down the bottom of the table.
I can't tell if that one goes in the middle pocket or not.
Oh, it's tight. It's tight. And if it does, it's off the draw. Earlier, we saw him play one of these and he hit it too hard. Or not one of the, it wasn't down the side, but
yeah.
He hit it too hard down the cushion. And if he hits this too hard.
And you can just drop it and put it on bottom of the table. Ooh. You don't need to do that.
And he's cut the red in, has he? The white's in, is it?
Now, this is Mike's first big chance.
Yeah.
First big chance. And you could put, to be honest, you play these in a million different ways, I think. Personally, I'm clearing the top two first. But
yeah, but this clearance is all about just making sure you're on your next ball. Mm-hmm. It's all position, really, because you shouldn't miss any of these parts. Apart from, it depends how comfortable. Does that one go comfortably into that bottom right, do you think? Mm. Or
it might be handy to play it and, well... I don't think he's going that way, but I was thinking you could pot it and free the pocket with the yellow out of the way, but I don't think you need to now. He's going to screw mid-table here. Choice of two. Don't go in off.
He's not in off, but he's snooking. Oh, that's unlucky.
He's snooking on both balls. That's bad luck, but also his own fault as well. Can you play it off the yellow? No.
That ain't a bad shot, that.
No. Is that the question for Jamie?
It depends. Do you think that one goes past the red in the middle?
I'm not sure it does.
You don't think it does, no.
Can you go off the side cushion? Jamie's looking at the top of the table to see if he can leave.
I think it's extremely tight.
But the one at the bottom of the table?
Yeah. Ooh.
You could go off the bottom cushion, I suppose.
I think he's playing the cut.
Okay. Oh, he's played the yellow.
Ooh. Not sure what he played there.
I think he played the cut.
You think he did?
The cut or the pot on the bottom right. Okay, Jamie's got a good chance now. Also plays a million ways.
Pushing the red safe by the looks of things.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Now, to be honest, a good friend of mine once told me if you've got two balls left on the table. If your opponent's got two balls left
you
on the table,
pot
one, because it's far easier to get a snooker behind one ball.
That's why I picked up the white, potted the one that was over the pocket, the one that he played.
Yeah, you have the white in the same situation now.
Yeah.
Might only have one ball to go after.
And it's not like that red is in a great position, is it?
No. I mean, he did try to play it up the cushion, but at the same time, leave it safe. But you've got a cushion, so you can't afford to leave it short.
Is it that one too hard? Much too hard, but it's an easy... Well, snooker or safety, play this pot. If you miss it,
I think you play the one to the left of the black.
Yeah.
The one to the left of the black, just roll it through, nice and steady, and you try and leave it in the bottom left-hand corner of the table, and you snooker him on both balls.
If you miss it.
If you miss it. If you pot it, you've got a great chance, because then you can play the one top left. The one over the corner pocket.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's playing what I think is the right ball. I'm certainly no expert, but I think this is the right ball. As long as he gets it fairly straight, he leaves Mike with a really hard shot.
He's got the pot.
He's got the pot. He's actually got the perfect angle to drop the one in the middle pocket and roll it through.
Yeah.
But he's also got the perfect angle on the top one as well. So he's choices
he's
here.
He's playing the one in the middle. Don't he's got down it. Quickly.
Don't mind it. Just drop it in. Roll it through 6 inches. He hasn't quite hit that hard enough.
Ooh.
He's not cueing the topspin shots very well. He's sort of not stabbing them, but he's not getting the topspin. He's not hitting the top of the ball. Now, I don't know if these two go or not. Tricky now to play the snooker. He's going for the snooker. He's got a cushion.
Oh, he's played that quite well.
He's played that well.
The only thing is, that top one of the two probably goes, is it? Do you think?
Yeah, definitely. Mike's a bit of trouble here. Is he going for the power? He is.
He's got it.
Got the hit.
He's hit it, and he's got a bit of luck. That's a good shot, that.
Touch there.
Also, that rate's gone over the middle.
Yeah, it's nice. Jamie can come off one, but I think he'd prefer to come off two or three and go in behind him.
Yeah. Oh, he's just looking at hitting him. Just wants the hit.
Okay. If he can hit it half ball on the top side, it'll go behind him. Ooh. Now, Mike's got a good chance here.
Is that not total?
It was a total, yeah. So
it's not a foul.
Not a foul. Can you screw across? Play in the middle pocket, leave it by the black somewhere. Or do you put it? Yeah, I don't mind that. That's a great shot.
Yeah, that's a good shot, that one.
As I said, leave it by the black somewhere. It's nice. Just drop that in. Bit tentative.
Yeah.
But he's got it.
Surely you can't miss this black, can you?
No.
Fair enough.
There we go. On the board. He's won his first frame.
Yeah, that was quite a big frame, really. That was
it is.
Good time for him to win. If he had left it much longer to win his first one.
3-1's no bother, is it? 3-1's no bother.
Two at this stage.
If it's 4-0, then it starts to be 4-0.
All the time you haven't got one on the board, you're always thinking. You're always thinking. Just not confident, really, are you? After you've got your first one, you feel a lot more confident.
Yeah,
I know that myself.
Definitely.
Jamie's gone for a toilet break. Maybe you think that's it, when Mike wins a frame in the solo, it's all over.
Yep.
Here he is, he's back. Ooh, trying to kick the camera over. A lot of side on that break.
Slightly miscued it. Good chance on reds here for Jamie.
Yeah, these reds have fell nicely.
See how confident he's feeling. If he wants to take the one over the corner pocket and go for it. Obviously that's your blocker if you're...
I'd play the plant.
It's a good chance. I think I would too. Leave the white on the brown spot on a snooker table.
Yeah.
A head spot, if you want to call it that. And, yeah. Great chance then.
Because even if, like, say you make a mistake later on, you've still got this ball over the pocket covering two of his yellow.
Precisely.
Just don't hit this hard. Just dead weight. That's the way he's played it. He's not quite got it over the pocket, though. Either.
See, now it's not over the pocket, there's no point it being there. Yeah. So I'm getting rid of the top two.
Yeah.
I'm probably playing the one top right first, so it's not too much angle. And then trying to screw out off the one top left. For choice of two, either middle.
Yeah. The speed this match is going, if it keeps going like this, could be here forever. I hope you're not working in the morning.
No, I'm...
Got the weekend off.
I'm Monday to Friday, boy.
Good.
Presentation night tomorrow night, and then the Berkshire series, Blackpool series.
Could still be playing
night.
By then.
Teach me to start a quarter of an hour late, won't it?
Yeah.
20 minutes late.
Either way, an hour for four frames is quite a long time, is it not?
Yeah. I tend to work on 10 minutes a frame.
You do?
Yeah. And if the top quality players, 7 or 8 minutes a frame. And he's not hit that at all.
That was quite a poor shot, that. Really, quite a poor shot. Can't you think you can still see it?
Don't know.
We can, but. He's done absolutely nothing with the white, maybe snooking himself and everything.
Might be able to see an edge of that one top right on the screen now. There's not much point in playing the bottom two.
No. Yeah, if you could. I suppose if we could play onto the bottom one, you're leaving nothing.
Yep. It's not a total, so...
He won't be three, he's left enough. I think he hit it too wide if I'm honest anyway.
You see Mike could play the plant down the cushion.
Not a bad shot, that one.
Yeah, it's covered the bag. It's a bit unfortunate that those two balls don't now plant.
Yeah.
Because apart from that, I fancy him to...
Knock them in, yeah.
To pop them up, put them all.
Oh, that's not... Maybe he left himself a plant, but...
Yep.
That's not the greatest. Good plant here, though. Back on track. Would you be going for these here, though? I think
probably not, to be honest. Okay, that one went through, that's good.
Oh, I didn't see that one.
Now, the one on the brown spot, you can play that dead straight. If he plays it well, he'll either cover the pocket or even possibly go off one of the two yellows and in the hole.
I think I'd be playing just to cover the pocket here, but...
Oh, he's gone that side of it.
Oh, what's he done?
I think he was trying to play our shot, but... That'll.
The bottom one goes.
Yeah, I think the bottom one goes.
And if you play it off the yellow, or you play it just to land on the other one, if you can obviously first you play the one in the middle, swing the white round, or try and swing the white round, touch right.
I think you play the one in the middle pocket confidently, swing it around the table, try and get yourself at the bottom of the table somewhere. Then you play the one on the bottom cushion, in off the yellow, through the pocket. Easy from here, though, isn't it, Arlie?
Yeah.
He's tried to do that, but he's stood up on the shot. And
yeah.
A few times when he's tried to hit him with a bit of pace, his body's come off the cue a little bit, and a couple into tight pockets, he's rattled them, and that one there, he's come off the cue again. So he's just stayed down the shots a little bit more. Mike can take the bottom left-hand pocket here.
That's a nice shot. He's potted it rather than doing that, but it's now them two together on the just above the one that's by itself.
How about this for a shot then? Play the one on the right hand side, dead weight, and rattle it, and leave the white stuck in behind the three yellows.
Yeah, that's the one. That's what he's playing.
I think he might play in the middle one of the three. Okay, I think he's just changed his mind. Now he's playing the middle one. Yeah.
Oh, he is. It's not bad. It's not bad at all.
That's taking control of the pocket, and he's freed his yellows to go now.
The other one. The other one of the three. It's gone to that. It's gone to that red.
Yeah.
What did you play here? Just roll to the one on the bottom cushion?
Yeah, probably. It's tricky, isn't it? Feel he can clear up here. So he just
what did you? This one's awkward slightly.
How about this for a shot? How about the long treble? Play the red off the top cushion.
Yeah.
In behind the two yellows.
It's a big, big shot. There's nothing else really. I think
I'm half joking, because the trouble with that shot is you probably leave him on his hard yellow.
And the thing is, though, I think he's just going to play to get them all out. Oh, I think that's what he played to do. He might have got them all out.
Has he put yellow?
He just pushed it even further, so he's got a bit of fortune there.
Good shot there from Mike.
Yeah.
Jimmy's not got much on here. Possibly play a snooker behind the black, maybe, but Jamie's in a bit of trouble here.
Play off the bottom of the three.
Yeah.
And then swing the white round and try and get it in behind the black. It doesn't look like that's what shot he's playing. It looks like he's just pushed it rolling to him. Which hasn't. Ooh, well.
He's called two on himself, fair play to him.
He's called two. Okay. It's changed things. It didn't look from here like it was two. It looked like.
It's close, isn't it?
Yeah, look at the cushion a bit.
So, what does Mike do here? He's obviously. He's got a free shot. Unless he goes in off. It's not going off.
For me, that wasn't the right shot anyway, but...
I don't mind freeing them. Maybe a bit hard. You didn't have to pot it, of course, with black ball rules. It's no different. If you pot it or not, you still need one more shot. One good cued shot. Ooh.
He's got a sneaker out of it.
He's got a second prize.
Did you come off the top cushion here?
I'm not sure what else you've got, mate, to be honest. If you can settle on the left hand of the three reds, that'd be handy, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Wow.
He's
played that way. And
pace approach. I'll tell you what, he's going to cover the pocket.
Black goes into the middle anyway, so it shouldn't make too much difference, but it's a bit fortune though. Maybe come slightly far there, but he'll expect to get this into the middle. Ooh, well.
It's a confident shot.
Yeah. He's played it well. It's a good shot, though.
Sometimes you just fancy them. Now, this is a bit tight in the middle. Do you just drop it in for a double, or do you...
He's looking at it in the corner, but for me it doesn't go. Well,
it's very tight. Skill shot.
For me, that was a wrong shot. I'd have left myself. Just leave yourself with any sort of shot at that black in the middle. Just drop that. Should have just dropped the yellow in. Leave yourself a shot.
So here, I think the shot is to play the red of the left red, either full in the face or. Clip off it thin and free them both. Send the black away, but play the other red next. Yep, that's the shot.
He's pushed the black a bit safe.
Yep. Play it a little bit firmer, get the black out a bit more.
Yeah.
And now he can top this one through. Top the other one through.
Yeah, you've got to make sure you leave yourself a nice angle on this one on the bottom cushion, just to run over to the black.
You don't need to move the black if you don't want to.
No, I don't need to move it. Played it aside?
Yeah, I don't think he meant to play it aside, to be honest. But he's got a nice angle there.
Do you be playing the pot? Or would you play the pot to move it, or just to roll in behind?
I think you just roll, try and...
Yeah. You end up hitting the ball too hard.
It's an inch off the cushion. You don't have to move it.
Just don't hit the ball too hard, yeah? That's all he's got to make sure he doesn't... Yeah, he's cued it nicely.
Snatch up.
Another...
Fraction hard, but you should expect him to get this, to be honest.
Probably another black you'd expect to get more.
Yeah, definitely.
Not a formality.
No.
He's got it. Yes.
And there we go. Yes.
Oh. That's another frame. I think that surprised me a bit, because I thought after Mike had won one, I thought maybe knock Jamie back a bit, but he'll be happy to get back on the winning trail again.
Yeah, definitely.
Minute frames on average so far, pretty much.
Yep. For 10 points, what's 70 divided by 5, Harley?
Yeah. 14.
Very good.
I'm so... that was quite slow, to be honest, wasn't it?
It's good skills, good maths.
Oh, he's kept the white out just. He does seem to be playing shots with a lot of side. Whether it's deliberate or...
I don't think it is. It's what's good about having the spotted white is you can learn from it, because I don't think he's meaning to do it. When he watches it back, he'll think, yeah, I'm actually queuing across a few of these. And
still getting them.
Playing a bit of unwanted side.
Cannon hasn't quite went his way there. Hasn't, well, just hit the wrong side of that black. Now he's ended up... The only shot he's got is a two-ball plant to cover the pocket. Oh, a plant to cover the pocket. Instead. It's a bit of a strange shot. Maybe I think he's just playing this red now. It's a bit like the black, he's just... Boy, I ended up putting the yellow, but he's just trying to cover the pocket here. Ooh, is it too hard?
He's freed it.
Do you not think it that bit hard, though? Just would you not have played dead weight just to cover the pocket back?
Yeah, I'd have played dead weight. He might win the game in one go of you all the time.
I think... Now, how aggressive are you? Do you cut the ball thin into the middle and smash them all open?
The way it's going at the moment, I think Jamie feels that if he just plays confidently, he's going to win more frames than he loses.
Yeah.
I think the way it's gone so far, he needs less chances than Mike to win a frame. And he seems to be playing more confidently of the two.
But I think that shot there, he's played it as a shot he didn't expect to get, because he's played the white safe at the same time. Because he pointed down towards the top right pocket to try and leave the white. I think I'm assuming he tried to leave the white there.
Yeah.
But
he's in danger of putting too many balls here.
Yeah, and just putting his way into a hole.
Yeah.
That's why he's just played a little safety shot.
Yeah. Just frame one of his balls. He's not left it in too good a position though.
Yeah. Could have done with that. Just staying in the middle of the table, but not left anything easy for Mike.
Mike's just bringing one of his balls out towards the pocket.
I think now Jamie's just got to just clip this over the pocket.
Yep. Again, he could do something more fancy, but that's what he's done.
It's come a bit off the cushion, off the pocket, but
Mike's looking at doing something.
Seem as if it was the pace to be able to make that red make the pocket.
That's a good shot from Mike then.
Yeah. Looking at coming off this yellow and pushing the white into the red. Maybe pushing the red away from the pocket. Oh no, he's pushing... Yeah. Oh, sorry. Oh, missed. Red it.
Yeah, I think he's playing this...
Getting this hard ball out and trying to push the red safe. Instead, he cut it over the pocket and left his yellow safe. Mm. It's not worked out quite how he would have wanted it, but...
No.
This red is very tight into this bottom corner.
I think it goes off the jaw if you're dead weight, if you're just behind it.
Yeah, but you wouldn't... No, you wouldn't... Well...
The good news is that you can drop it in because you've got reds into the opposite corner. So just screw it down the table. Somewhere near the blue spot would be ideal.
I've always thought when Mike plays, he looks so angry. You don't think?
Oh, might be playing the one bottom left here, to be honest. Just try and get it over the pocket.
The only problem with that, if you overcut it slightly, then yellow's over the pocket.
Yeah,
but
it's a confident pot.
Now he's got the long one up into the corner.
How about the?
But at the same time, Mike got a bit of fortune here.
Ooh.
He has got a little bit, but if Jamie can get the white towards the top of the table, top right-hand corner of the table, then he could get it safe. But or maybe I'm looking at... Do you just flick your hard ball off the top cushion? Maybe just flick your hard ball off the top cushion and then leave the white in the top right.
Yeah, yeah, just double it back.
Oh yeah, I'm not even looking. Oh.
If I was doubling it back there, he's...
pushed the red safe. He's got a bit of fun, a bit lucky there again. But can he pop this and get it out? He's tried to. I think he might have just moved that enough.
Yeah, that's close. Or do you go for a reverse double, middle pocket?
I think, yeah, because you're as good as you'll be on it. You're pretty much perfect on it, and you're running the white round. Yep. Oh, he's running off. Has he moved that one? He hasn't. He's just put another one safe now. This is a massive chance for Mike.
Yeah.
Absolutely massive.
The red does go bottom left now. He's moved it enough. If he's not feeling it, he can either pop the yellow or the red. Pop the yellow and screw it back, I suppose.
Yeah. Oh, he hasn't got into the white.
That's okay, you can play the top one first. Just play the top one. He's not looking at the top one.
He's like, he wants a thin cut. Mm. Only trouble with this is the white's coming around to leave him on the yellows if he misses. Or is it played it dead weight?
It's okay.
Where's the white?
He knows where Jamie's yellows are.
I think...
that he can just...
just roll the... will yeah. He just screw the white behind the black here?
Yeah, just screw it back.
I think the trouble here, though, is the red might come across and move the white out of the way.
You could play the double, actually. Play a double and leave it on the bottom cushion.
He's missed the snooker. Now. This isn't... nah, it's... I think... do you play the shot? You've got to play the pot, haven't you? You've kind of got nothing else.
The thin one. You could just roll to the left-hand edge and... leave him the hard one down the table.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, just that way you're putting them both, so neither of them go. And
yeah, true.
I think if you got a shot here.
Go for it. Where the black is, just a thin clip.
Yeah.
You know that you can't foul by missing it because you've got the other yellow next to it. So go for a thin pot as thin as you can, knowing that. If you miss it completely, you'll hit the other one. You almost got to try and miss it. Play to miss it. Hit it so thin.
Yeah. Like you taught me this one, you always aim for the... whenever you got these sort of shots, you always aim for the far draw. Mm. Obviously, it's not easy to aim for any draw there.
No, no, absolutely.
You'd be aiming for the pocket, but you always want to aim for the far draw.
Hit it, but it's two shots.
Yeah, Noble's hit a cushion there after contact, so that would be two shots. And once again, I say there's another massive chance for Jamie. I mean, for Mike. Sorry.
For Mike, yeah. Do you try and be creative and just flick off the black? Surely the black.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Just get the black out, would you not? Mm. Instead, he's decided to get the yellow out.
But he's okay here. If he gets the pot, he might...
get a little can.
Yep. Looks like he's screwing it.
Yeah, it looks like he's queuing down on this white ball. It's a good pot. And he's got... he's got a double in the middle.
Reverse double. Yep, so not reverse double, but double across the table.
He's got one... he can leave the white pretty much safe, no matter where.
Oh, he's looking at the long double.
I wouldn't be playing the long double there. He is.
He's playing the long double.
He is playing it.
Mike goes for Reds. A little bit of a controversial choice given where the yellows are bottom right. Nice pot from Jamie. He's actually played it too well. Here's a shot for you then, Harley. How about the yellow plant on the right hand side and send the white into the black and the red?
Well, yeah. It's a big, big shot if you play it. But if it comes off, you get all your balls out. You have a chance, but I'm not sure I'd be playing it.
He's played it. But he seems, when he hits it harder,
gets up off the shot.
Yeah,
too
he loses his form, and the harder he hits it, the less control of the cue ball, the cue he has. Nice shot from Mike. Mike cueing a little bit better now. He's got over his early nerves.
Yeah.
4-2. Game on, Harley.
Yeah.
I think he's looking to cover the bag bottom right here as well.
I don't know if they've agreed to have a break every so often, have they?
I don't know. Yeah, if you have breaks, we might be here a while, Harley. I think he's tried to screw straight back and to screw into to yellows there, and he's put it aside again and finished top of the table. It's not the end of the world, though, because you can drop this in and play the one in the middle pocket and try and split them up.
Yeah, he can, but he didn't need to hit it that hard, really. I understand he played the cannon, but he's dead almost
is he
straight.
This?
I think he's kind of potting himself into a hole here. Unless I know, well, probably doesn't go. Top this row. play the two that are next to each other near the black, and maybe it plants the one near the middle in.
Plant, or it goes off the red first.
Yeah, I think something like that.
I think he's going to play this dead white, and if it goes in, okay. If it just stops over the hole, it's not the end of the world.
I think maybe he just played that.
That's what he's played. Go for it.
Yeah. I just want to... Close to if that goes. I think Mike's going to move him now so it doesn't go.
Yep.
That's a good, great pot, great pot. He's potting well, very well. He seems to get got a bit of a step in it, like, just a bit of more.
Yeah.
Don't know what it is, but just walking like, around the table with a bit more conviction. Yeah.
I think this might go off the black. He's looking at playing it off the black. It's very close.
Would you play to... I suppose I think he's got too much angle on this one.
If he plays the one next to the black and screws the white straight back to roughly where it is now.
That was a strange shot, but...
Is he going for a double and freeze one of those side cushions? Isn't he?
I think it's changed in the last few frames, I think. Earlier on it was Jamie being the aggressor and now...
Yeah.
Mark... I mean, Mike. Right, joining me in the commentary box now because AJ's went to go get some food. Bradley.
Hello, Ali, mate. You alright?
Yeah, I'm alright. You?
Yeah, not too bad.
Obviously,
so
he's
kind of just been outside. So what's happening here? He's on what at the moment?
Jamie's on yellows, but at the moment, I think it's changed. It started off Jamie being the aggressor, being probably playing better of the two.
Yeah.
But now. Probably Mike playing slightly better and being more aggressive, trying to make things happen.
Sorry about the noise in the background if you can hear it. There's a darts tournament going on down here at the moment.
It's a good pot.
As well.
Does Place that black go busy. Anywhere? Does it but go anywhere? Let's see if it
Laverick looks a bit more confident today, doesn't he?
Yeah. More than he was against you. Battered him.
It's a name, Harley.
Chance here for Jamie. I think he's trying to make something happen now. Trying to walk around the table a bit quicker. Get something going for himself.
Can't actually see the screen from here. It's better.
Still got them two that are together. They both go into the left. I'd say they both go into that left middle, but just getting on them.
Yeah.
It's anything but easy, that.
What's the change the camera angles?
You got this. You wanted that one?
I can't really see from that angle.
Oh, once again, he's done that twice now. He's had the same shot twice. Again. He's trying to swing the white round. And he's ended up screwing the white ball rather than getting the thing. Just wanted to stun the white and swing the white round the reds. But instead. He's ended up snookering himself. It's a good hit, but...
It's not too bad.
The thing is, what do you play? Plant to
what
get the
if I was Laverick?
Off? Or just play a safety shot? Get one of your two out at the top and just put the white safe? Looks like he's playing the plant to get
the
other
probably
one out.
I'd play the plant first, definitely.
Not sure I would have. But.
It's just that tricky ball he's playing now, really.
I wouldn't be playing this yet. I'll be wanting to play good safety. It's a good shot, that. Good shot. Because I don't think he's left the one near the black spot on.
So how did this game come about then, do you know? Did who ask who to play each other?
I think just because, I don't know really.
No?
I don't know. I know that they played each other, like I said earlier, they played each other a couple of months ago.
Oh, did they? And yeah. Now it come about, is it? Do you know who won?
Jamie won, actually. It was quite a really tight game, 21-19.
Oh, that's all right. Close?
Yeah, very close. Looks like it's going to be the same way tonight. Like I was saying to AJ earlier, keep going at this speed.
Be until like 3 in the morning.
Real. We've been going for over an hour and a half now. We've only played 7 frames.
Good job I ain't got work tomorrow. Thought it'd be busier than it is, to be fair, but
yeah, apparently, well, at the moment, just filled with players wanting Laverick to.
Laverick's
a good
got he's got good support with him.
Yeah,
today.
Laverick's got quite a few players with support people down here supporting him. Jamie's only got the one at the moment, just one of his mates. His dad's and a few others are meant to be coming down later, apparently. Oh, he thinks he can get through to this one. From my point of view.
That wasn't the greatest shot I've seen.
From my point of view, that looked like two.
That's what I thought as well.
I thought it yellow onto red, but I don't know. He hasn't called it upon himself. At that pace, you can never call it.
No.
He's hit so hard.
Had the one in the middle. The one next to the two reds, maybe yeah. Screw back a couple of inches, put the yellow in the bottom left-hand corner, and then the yellow next to the red goes, so play that, and then on the black.
It's not an easy plant by any means. Not sure I'd have stunned it, but...
It's a good shot.
Be struggling.
Have you got an angle to come back down?
Is that plant? Is it? Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, just a little angle. Sorry, Mike's stood in front of that bar cam. You played it this way around?
Yeah.
Yeah, I suppose it's not a bad way to go, mate.
Oh, come on, Dad!
Well,
I think it was his first shot, which was wrong, to be honest with you.
He didn't quite get... I'd have been topping it through rather than stunning it, would you not?
Yeah.
But it's not the easiest clearance with two shots. Not the easiest.
Unlucky. Tried going into the reds as well, I think.
Yeah. But I think...
Not really sure why, because that red goes in the middle.
It does, yeah. Now, this. I think you've got to play it now, have you not? You play it now, yeah?
Yeah.
He's got it. Ooh.
He's got to play the plant now. He's got no choice, really.
He's got the thin plant. And this white could be coming around to snooker himself. He's got down quick.
No, I don't think he will.
He's got down very quick. He's played it dead weight. Oh, he's missed it. And what a chance this is for Jamie. Massive, really, because this is a chance. This is a frame. Mike was in complete control.
All Jamie has to do is drop the one in the middle.
He's got
an angle now to come back down for the yellow at the bottom.
Yeah, just all you got to do, drop this in absolute dead weight. The white's coming down for the yellow. The white's coming down for the yellow on the bottom cushion. And, well, just getting on the black, really, is the shot. Ooh, he's left himself too much angle here.
He's a bit high.
Pot it and leave yourself a shot. Just leave yourself any shot on that black.
That sprang off the cushion, didn't it?
What would you... Surely you can't play for position here. You just got... Just pot it. Just focus on the pot. Leave yourself any sort of shot with that black. These are the shots that are going to affect the sort of way this match goes, I think. It's a great pot. It's a fantastic pot. Now, so he needs another one. He hates queuing overable. He says to me he hates queuing overable. Let's see how much he hates it. He hates him down the cushion, apparently, and he hates queuing overable.
So this has got a miss in it, then? Is that what you're trying to say?
Surely you can't pot it. If he pots this... He's been lying to me all this time.
Well, they're all there if he misses it, so he needs to make sure.
Yeah. Quite a big shot, this one. Yes, Jamie! What? It's a great shot, that, from Jamie.
That one?
Yeah.
Whoops.
Oh, no, the plus.
What? Was it five?
Oh, no, five, sorry. Give him six.
It's a great black.
It's a fantastic black. So much from hating queuing over balls and down the cushion. Make sure your ears sweat loads. I'm sure you guys don't care, but there's some sort of team. There's a team called Millwall playing.
I'm trying to watch both at the same time. You know that partial curfew, are you?
Right, well, now, Jamie, play the one he's nearest to. Get that away from the middle pocket. Play it up into the top corner, probably. Thanks, AJ, just ruining the scoreboard for us.
Was that you leaning on buttons, was it?
That's all right, AJ. You just sit there eating your food and destroying the scoreboard. Right now. Surely this game's got to quicken up at some point. Surely. Ooh, is it a bit hard? Is it that a bit hard? Oh, it's just straight behind that yellow. Meaning nothing goes.
Is that red cut into the left pocket? Or is it a bit? No, I don't.
That one there doesn't look like it. You could probably get a better view if you lean over.
Play it off the red. No, I don't.
It doesn't there. Play it off the red, yeah, I suppose. Can you get through to that?
Even if he just leaves it over the pocket, he's then got that pocket covered from that yellow, which is on the bottom rail.
At the moment, he has no shot, does he? So he has no real shot other than that.
He told me earlier when I was practicing with him earlier, and he told me he don't really like playing shots like that.
What, off a ball?
Off balls, yeah.
That's why he's playing. He could get through to it. He tried to get it out of the other ball at the same time.
I don't think he tried to do that.
You don't?
No. You're laughing at my hair, dude. It's better than yours, Harley, mate. You've had a cow's lick at the front of your hair for ages, since I've ever known you.
Terrible, I can't be bothered. That's my excuse, at least.
What barbers do you go to?
I go to, what's it, the vets?
Tyler's Cutters.
Oh, he's left Jamie on one of his hard balls, eh? I'd be playing this one into the bottom right-hand corner. Leaving yourself on the one near the black spot and just pushing that one over the corner.
Yeah. Sorry, I like to look at stuff like this. That don't go.
No.
He's got to play the red in the middle of the three. That one there that he's playing now.
He's screwing back.
Well, the other red don't go, does it? So.
I know, but you could have played the one in the black spot, that one.
Black spot, yeah.
Just covered this pocket. Yeah. But I suppose he's left himself a shot here. Does he
he's
play
in trouble
this to
here, really.
Yeah, he's putting himself into a hole, really. He'd be doing well to win the frame from here.
Needs but to try and keep balls on the table or cover a bag or...
Yeah, and at the moment there's not really many good balls to cover a bag with. I say you play the pot now, stun it in, try and get the ball off the cushion, and just hope you land on it at an angle that you can do something with. Ah, shut up, Grover.
Much win off, you didn't see.
I'll have you know. You're not a better pool player, and you're not a better commentator, so...
Who said that?
Grover.
Duh.
Me.
I think he's right.
Yeah. You think what you want. Come on then, Grover, I'll play you for money. Next game on air.
And my money would be on Grover.
Oh, he's put the black safe there. Run safe here. Might have to play a plant here. Whoa, he thinks he can cut this. Does he?
I think he's looking to cut it and get go into the black. But
surely it doesn't cut, and he's getting his red. This could be suicide. Surely not. Oh. Doesn't look like it, guys. Got the red. Tell you what, big shot here.
Slam this one down here, play the skill shot.
Slam this in, round off two cushions, get your red out on the top left corner. Obviously. We make it sound easy, it's anything but.
Yeah, play the skill shot. Fuck it.
Play the skill shot now?
Probably, yeah.
Not a bad shot. Leave him, make him play the black. I think that's what he's trying to do. Because that black is not easy at all where it is.
No, it's not.
If I'm Laverick, you want to try and get that black off the cushion. But now, can he play this, slam this one up the top and get his ball out? Yeah, Grover, you're a dart man. I'd stick to that. No good at pool.
There's a darts tournament down here, Grover. I'm surprised you're not here, mate.
Every Friday. He played for the skill shot here. Or he could he play this one in the middle and then play cannon on red and maybe pop the yellow at the same time?
The skill shot's really easy. The ball's right over the hole.
It's not really easy.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's really easy.
Yeah, it is.
Absolute tapping, that one. Good pot, but he's in trouble. Can't do much with this. He's got to play a speculative double.
Looks like I'm going Wembley next Sunday.
You're going to go?
Yeah.
Millwall.
0-0 at the moment.
25 minutes in, Millwall 0-0. Of course, in the first leg, they beat Bradford 3-1. Oh, it's a fantastic double, that. But unfortunately,
he loves a double, Jamie
unfortunately,
does.
That black might be too close for this double to go. I mean, too close to the cushion, sorry.
Yeah.
Bit confused.
Well, they're doing having a break after the next frame, are they?
Not this one, but the next one. I think so, after every 10 frames. Oh, it didn't go as he flipped a treble. Oh. And he's got the blackout. That's a mess.
He needs to clear these old Mickey, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. It's a massive chance. Played that well.
Perfect.
Yeah. Perfect.
And there you go, that's 5-4.
Tight game. I think after this one we're going to have like a 5 or 10 minute break. Great break, but unfortunately they haven't failed perfect. I suppose there's a dish on, just not as easy as you'd like. Brad?
Yeah.
What'd you make of that?
If you think so, mate.
Sit. Grover. You think he's...
Does he play for his postman's team, does he?
Play for the postman's, Grover. Bradley's laughing at you. Thinks you're stupid.
Is he shaved off his stupid beard yet?
He looks like an Arab.
Does he?
Covered the pocket, it's not bad, sure. I think at the moment Mike's potting better than Jamie.
Yeah.
I think Jamie's just taking his chances slightly better.
Well, Jamie's finished. Every time he's got to the black, he's actually potted,
potted it. Apart from the last frame. It wasn't an easy double by any means.
It's hard.
Oh, a miscue. Is it going to be two shots? He's been fortunate enough to make a cushion.
But yeah, like I said, you can tell Grover, if my five-a-side football team wants to play his postman's team, then I'm more than happy to arrange a game for cash, if he wants.
That's hurt him, that, Grover. That's hurt him. Never tell him you're better than him at football. It's a good part. You can get it just... Got to leave himself a shot to get back down here. Coming out of retirement. I understand you have grey hairs, but you're not 40, you're not 65 yet, not quite 65.
I think there'll be a break after this frame, lads.
So good shot, but does it go? Does this one go? Yes, of course it does. Flies. Stupid.
I don't know why you looked at it.
It'd be nice if Jamie can go in 6-4 up into the break. He did hit that at the beginning of the match.
Yeah. Yes.
6-4, Jamie.
Sorry, that was pretty bad of me, to be fair. I just said yes when Jamie potted the ball.
Biased commentating.
Sorry, Laverick. But I've got a bit of money on Jamie, so.
All right, then. Well, we'll see you again in about 10 minutes.
We're just going to turn the stream off for 5 minutes. Just let the batteries recharge. The players are on a 10-minute break. So we'll see you in a few minutes.